Hi, I'm Joni, and you're watching Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking on YouTube. Today I'm here along the Mendocino Coast. I'll be making a Pennsylvania Dutch chicken. Stay tuned. Here are the ingredients today that I'm using for the Pennsylvania Dutch chicken. I have 4 pounds of skinless chicken thighs. I am doubling this recipe because it was such a good buy on chicken thighs. They were under $1 a pound. I also have salt and pepper, red apples, canola oil, some sauerkraut, some whole onions, these are frozen, apricot halves, or apricots, however you'd like to say it, some raisins, and I'm using golden raisins, and some brown sugar. These thighs have the skin on, but it's really easy to take it off, especially if they have been frozen and then thawed out. You just have to kind of reach under and loosen up the skin, and when it's like this, it comes off very easily. Just pull it around. Discard the skin. For the recipe, 4 thighs is usually equal to about 2 pounds. Go ahead and salt and pepper them. If you're using a 12-inch oven or a 10-inch oven, I would recommend 4 thighs. I'll be using a 14-inch and I'll be cooking up 8 thighs. Just sprinkle with salt and pepper to taste. Now that I've seasoned the chicken with salt and ground black pepper, I'll core and thinly slice up the apple. I'll also preheat the Dutch oven to 350 degrees. For the smaller Dutch oven, core and thinly slice 1 apple. I like to use this because it just works so well to get the core out. And then you can slice those even thinner. For the larger oven, I'm going to use 2 red apples. Here I've set up the coals on the bottom. I have 11 coals. I'm going to put the Dutch oven on top to heat it up, put some oil in it so I can sauté that chicken. For a 12-inch Dutch oven, I'll use 1 jar of sauerkraut, which is 16 ounces, the onions, which were frozen, 1 dozen apricot halves, 1/2 cup of raisins, and 1/4 cup of brown sugar. Again, I'm making twice as much in the recipe. This is for a 12-inch. If you want the 14-inch, double that. 32 ounces of sauerkraut, about 30 ounces of the onions, 2 dozen apricots, 1 cup of raisins, and 1/2 cup of sugar. While that chicken is sautéing, I'm going to go ahead and combine the apple and the remaining ingredients. I'm going to do it in this tin foil pan so I can get everything mixed together, which includes the apricot halves, apples, raisins. I'm going to be putting in some of these frozen onions. My grandma used to be able to buy these in a can, and I think you probably still could find them, but I went ahead and used petite whole onions. I also have some brown sugar. I packed it pretty tightly. And sauerkraut. I did not drain it. You want to have that liquid in there. We used to make sauerkraut. We had a crock out in the garage, and my grandma taught my dad how to make it. He taught me how to make it, but I actually haven't made any since my college days, quite a few years ago. You either really like sauerkraut, or I guess you don't, but having been raised on sauerkraut, I do like it a lot. Once you get all of those in there combined, take your chicken out of the Dutch oven, give it a quick wipe, and then you can insert this mixture, stir it around, and you're going to tuck the chicken into the sauerkraut. The chicken's been sautéed nicely on both sides. It's got a little bit of a brown to it. They were about 6 minutes on each side. I'll remove them from the Dutch oven and drain the grease out of that. Then I'll go ahead and add that fruit and sauerkraut mixture. I'll put that fruit and sauerkraut mixture all in the Dutch oven. I still have the coals underneath because I want to try to get it back to 350. As I said, I'm using a 14-inch here. So for a 14-inch Dutch oven, I need 32 coals total. I'll have 21 on top, and I currently have 11 under the bottom. For a 12-inch Dutch oven, you need 25 coals total, 17 on top and 8 on the bottom. Once I have those in place, I'm going to just kind of tuck the chicken down inside, and then I'll cover it up with some of that mixture, and especially the sauerkraut. This would have been one of the dishes that my grandmother said and met the criteria for 7 sweets and 7 sours, which was a custom in Pennsylvania Dutch for the hostess that's at the table. Now that I have those chicken thighs tucked down inside, I'm going to put the top heat back on, 350. I want to bake for 30 minutes, and the juices in the chicken should run clear. Here you have it, 30 minutes later, Pennsylvania Dutch chicken. Time to activate the smell-o-vision. Hope I don't fog up the camera here, or I should say steam it up. I hope you find this food comforting and filled with rich flavors. Many of the recipes that I use come from Germany and Austria. I'd like to give my thanks and a debt of gratitude to those traditional German cooks of yesteryear who created many fine recipes I have in my file. The recipes often had to utilize foods found in the Eastern Dutch Pennsylvania region, as it wasn't always possible to secure the original items needed to create these tasty dishes. If you have to substitute prunes or plums for the apricots, go ahead and do so. Be inventive. It'll be delicious whichever way you decide to use it. Thanks for watching today's webisode. Hope you enjoyed it. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors. And until the next time, happy trails to you!